Hello dear students, today the topic of the class is region of convergence. The topic is from the Z transforms. In this class you'll be understanding what's the definition of ROC and its properties. So let us start the class. ROC stands for region of convergence. What is its use? So it is, we'll see its properties, then you can clearly understand what is its significance. So as you know, the Z transform is a mathematical tool for the analysis of a discrete time signal, let it be x of n, and linear time invariant discrete time system. So Z transform is a mathematical tool for the analysis of discrete time signals and discrete time LTI systems. Z transform of a discrete time signal x of n is given by this equation. Z transform of x of n is equal to capital X of z equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of n z to the power minus n. This, what is region of convergence? The set of values of z for which the magnitude, the set of values of z for which the magnitude of x of z is finite. The set of values of z for which x of z magnitude is finite is called region of convergence, ROC. Properties of ROC. The first point, the ROC is a ring or disk in the z plane centered at the origin. Second property, the ROC cannot contain any pole or poles. The ROC cannot contain poles. Third property, if x of n is a finite duration, what is x of n? A discrete time signal or a discrete time sequence. It can be of two types, finite duration or infinite duration. If x of n is a finite duration causal sequence, then the ROC is the entire z plane except z is equal to 0. For finite duration, ROC is the entire z plane except z is equal to 0. If x of n is a finite duration anti-causal sequence, then the ROC is the entire z plane except at z is equal to infinity. Next, fifth point, if x of n is a finite duration two-sided sequence, then the ROC is the entire z plane except at z is equal to 0 and z is equal to infinity. So what are these three properties? If x of n is a finite duration causal sequence, ROC is entire z plane except z is equal to 0. Finite duration anti-causal, entire z plane except z is equal to infinity. X of n finite duration two-sided sequence, then ROC is entire z plane except z is equal to 0 and z is equal to infinity. This x of n can be an infinite duration sequence also. If x of n is an infinite duration two-sided sequence, then the ROC consists of a ring in the z plane bounded on the interior and exterior by a pole. This will be clear, more clear in the next part, which I will be explaining now. If x of n is an infinite duration two-sided sequence, the ROC consists of a ring in the z plane bounded on the interior and exterior by a pole, not containing any poles. Coming to the seventh point, the ROC of a LTI stable system contains the unit circle. Eighth point, the last point, the ROC must be a connected region in the Z plane. Okay, so these are the eight properties of ROC. So what is ROC? The set of values of Z for which X of Z is finite is known as ROC. So here there is, I have explained with few examples. If x of n is a finite duration and if x of n is infinite duration. So first condition, let us take it for finite sequence. For finite sequence, if x of n is a finite sequence, okay, if x of n is finite, it can be a causal signal, an anti-causal, or it can be two-sided signal. So here I have taken one example. If it is a causal signal means the right-sided sequence. If the amplitude is 3, 2 and 1, okay, this is one finite duration causal sequence at 0, 1 and 2. At 0 its amplitude is 3, at 1 the amplitude is 2 and at time 2 its amplitude is 1. So it's a causal sequence, it's a finite duration because it's having some finite values. So what is ROC for this? ROC in the Z plane. What is Z plane? Real part of Z and imaginary part of Z. For a causal sequence, finite duration, it is entire Z plane except Z is equal to 0. Okay, so ROC is entire Z plane except Z is equal to 0. Okay, so how do we represent this ROC? By the shaded part. ROC is entire Z plane in the Z plane except Z is equal to 0. So for finite duration causal signal, ROC is entire Z plane except Z is equal to 0. So you can write ROC is entire Z plane except Z is equal to 0. Let us see the second example for finite duration. If x of n is an anti-causal signal, anti-causal signal means a left hand side sequence. Here the other sample's values are amplitude is 0. So it is shown like this. Let us draw x of n a finite duration. So at 0 the amplitude is 3. At minus 1 the amplitude is 2, at minus 2 the amplitude is 1. It's a finite duration, it's having some finite amplitude, finite values. So it is an anti-causal sequence, that is on the left hand side, left handed sided signal. What is ROC for this? ROC for a finite duration anti-causal signal is entire Z plane except Z is equal to infinity. We have already solved these problems in our previous class. So for finite duration anti-causal signal, ROC is entire Z plane except Z is equal to infinity. Okay, so what is ROC here? ROC is entire Z plane except Z is equal to infinity. Let us see the third example. If x of n is finite duration and a two-sided sequence. Okay, finite duration at 0. Let the amplitude be 3. At 1, the amplitude is 2. At 2, the amplitude is 1. At minus 1, the amplitude is 2. At minus 2, the amplitude is 1. So it's a finite duration, two-sided. On both the sides, you are having the samples. It's a two-sided finite duration sequence or signal. So what will be the ROC here? ROC is entire Z plane except Z is equal to 0 and Z is equal to infinity. To see this problems on this topic, you can refer the previous video. In that I have explained you how to calculate ROC. So for two-sided sequence, the ROC is entire z plane except z is equal to 0 and z is equal to infinity. ROC for two sided sequence is entire z plane except z is equal to 0 and z is equal to infinity. Okay, so these three are the examples of finite duration: causal signal, anti-causal and two-sided signal. So let us now see how ROC for infinite duration. So second set, let us say it for if x of n is infinite duration. Infinite duration or infinite sequence. So for infinite duration, again it can be x of n causal signal, x of n can be anti-causal, or it can be two-sided. So if x of n is infinite duration causal signal, causal means right hand side signal or sequence 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's say causal sequence. So you are having infinite samples till infinity. It's a causal sequence. What will be its ROC? ROC is entire Z plane greater than than a circle of radius R1. Real part of Z and imaginary part of Z. This is Z plane. So where is ROC for this one? ROC is outside this circle of radius R1. The ROC is outside this circle of radius R1. Okay. Now let us see. If x of n is infinite duration anti-causal signal, x of n is infinite duration anti-causal sequence 0, minus 1, minus 2. It's an infinite duration having infinite number of samples. It's an infinite duration anti-causal, that means it's having samples on the left hand side of the origin. So what is ROC for such sequence? ROC is, let us first draw the Z plane, real of Z, imaginary of Z. ROC is inside the circle of radius R1. The circle of radius R1. So for an anti-causal infinite duration, ROC is inside this circle, inside the circle of radius R1. Now let us see if x of n is infinite duration, if x of n is infinite duration two-sided signal, two-sided sequence or signal. Zero, one, two, three, minus one, minus two, minus 3. It's a two-sided sequence. Why? Because you are having samples on both the sides of the origin, and of infinite duration you are having samples. So the ROC for a two-sided infinite duration is a ring, real part, real of Z, imaginary of Z. This is a Z plane. Okay, so the ROC is a ring here. First circle is of radius r1. Another circle of radius r2. Okay, so where is ROC for a two-sided sequence? It will be a ring, that is between r1 and r2. Okay, so for an infinite duration causal signal, where is ROC? ROC is mod z greater than mod r1. For infinite duration anticausal sequence, the ROC is mod z less than mod r1. For two-sided infinite duration, ROC is between r1 and r2. Okay, I hope we have understood how to draw the ROCs and what are the properties of ROC. So what is ROC? The ROC is the set of values of z for which x of z converges. So here we have seen, if x of n is finite duration, okay, and then we have seen this x of n, the discrete time signal or discrete time sequence, can be an infinite duration. Okay, for infinite duration again you can have causal signal, anti-causal and two-sided signal or two-sided sequence. Likewise, for infinite duration you can have causal signal, anti-causal signal and two-sided signal. Okay, so what is ROC for a finite duration causal sequence? Entire z plane except z is equal to 0. For anti-causal, ROC is entire z plane except z is equal to infinity. For two-sided sequence, ROC is entire z plane except z is equal to 0 and z is equal to infinity. For infinite duration causal signal, the ROC is mod z greater than circle of radius r1. For anti-causal, ROC is mod z less than r1. For two-sided, it is between r1 and r2. Okay, so these are the ROCs of x of n finite and infinite duration. So what is an ROC? ROC is a ring or a disk in the z place centered at the origin. It cannot contain any pole. Okay, I hope you have understood the class. If you have any queries, you can post in the comments. Thank you. Good luck, students.